In this quick start video, we'll be going through the fundamentals of the Auto Depth of Field tool in the High Definition Render pipeline and an overview of the component. Let's begin by adding the component to your GameView camera. Head to Window, Hibiki Entertainment, Depth of Field, Add Auto Depth of Field. This will automatically add the Auto Depth of Field component to your active game camera and target it in the inspector. You may get a window pop-up stating to enable physical camera. This is the Link to FOV to Physical checkbox in the camera settings and should be enabled to provide focal length control. However, you may choose not to. You may also get a second pop-up window suggesting to add the glass tag to your tags and layer panel. This is to ensure that you can use the glass check functions in the component. Again, this is optional and solely based on your scene composition. Auto Depth of Field is now fully functional and will work when in play mode. It is important to note that the Auto Depth of Field system here works on objects with a collider, but can be further enhanced with the Unity Volume Framework in any other given case. It is also a non-destructive workflow, so everything can be added or removed as if enabling or disabling certain functions without harming your project integrity. Now that the component is added, let's briefly go over its functionality, as you will likely need to further tune for your scene and volumes. You can see more on this in another video. At the top header, you have a banner that is a shortcut to the online documentation. Click it to load it up. You can also find the offline version locally under Hibiki Entertainment, Auto Depth of Field. You'll see the PDF file there. Under Global Settings, there are two options: the active camera you want to run the component in, and Presets, where you can load and save presets. By default, Auto Depth of Field ships with two presets. Default, which is a fast autofocus change with a shallow depth, perfect for focusing on detailed objects faster. The second preset is Safe Standard. This preset is a good all-around setup that will give you a basic look and feel in an internal or external scene. You can make more presets for your camera and the Unity Volume Framework to further fine-tune your scene specifics. More on that in another video. Next is the setup. These options are for autofocus and how it interacts with your scene. Interact layers are your object layer tags. FOV multiplier is how much of the camera frustum is used to calculate focus points from 0 to 100%. You can visualize this within Scene View by checking Show Gizmos in the debug settings at the bottom of the component. Accuracy is how many rays are cast. This may affect performance if you increase it beyond 1. We recommend keeping it at 1, which makes 9 focus points, similar to a basic camera. Max distance is the distance of the autofocus in units. This is helpful when it comes to dynamically tune a tight scene versus large open-world scenes, and is directly responsible for the two aperture settings below. Finally, you have transition time. This is how long it takes the autofocus distance to change. We often find 0.3 has a nice balance between a natural feel and fast enough not to be too noticeable, but this is something you may have to tune based on the dynamics of your project. Moving down to the depth of field settings. Focal length is the distance from the lens to the focal point in millimeters. This is also where the link check tag comes into play, as it links the FOV. This is a Unity standard function and 1-to-1. Base aperture and extended aperture are important for tuning your scenes. The base aperture is the default that the camera will set when an object is found, and the extended aperture is for when an object isn't found. This is good for when you're moving in through a dense forest and then coming out into open plains. The quality settings. high-quality filtering, and physically-based checkboxes are quality settings for the Unity Depth of Field post effect. These are one-to-one representations. The glass check setting we will cover in another video. That's all for the quick start. Please tune in to our other tutorial videos to find out more. If you're having any problems, you can refer to the documentation community on our Discord or submit a ticket to us to give you dedicated support. Until next time.